The Pepsi Center is the spot in Denver, Colorado, as the Chicago Blackhawks are in town to face the Avalanche. The Avs trying to get their first win of the season against Chicago. We have our opening faceoff, and we're underway. The Avalanche with the puck. TJ Hentschik feeds it ahead. Stewart, Hentschik's shot, and Javi Bulin makes the first save of the game for the Chicago Blackhawks. 2-0 this season against the Avs. The puck comes around the boards out towards center ice, and Patrick Kane, who was a question mark before the start of this game, sends it across for Sharp. He had a high ankle sprain that has kept him out, but he is back in the lineup and also dangerous. He is number 88, the Calder Trophy winner, the Rookie of the Year in the National Hockey League, centering up the slot. He goes all the way down the ice and into the Chicago zone. Javi Bulin will shoot it across. It's launched in from center ice by Walker into the Colorado zone. Backcourt, defenseman Ruslan Soleil. He finds Scott Hannon, the Avalanche defenseman, shoots it ahead to center ice. Milan Hayduk moves in with speed, cutting in, pass across, and it hopped over the stick of Wojtek Volski. That pairing in the last game for the Avs resulted in 2 goals against Nashville and helped the Avalanche win against the Predators. They were just a great duo in that game against Nashville.
And Mike, the key to it was Volski reacting to the passes of Hayduk. On both the goals, it was Volski taking a pass.
Here's a pass from Volski, trying to return it over to Hayduk. Swatted back behind the net. Picked up. Smith had a chance. That was deflected behind the net. Hayduk grabs it. Centering try. Goes over to the far wing for Volski. Picked up again by Hayduk. Slides it back towards the point for Soleil. He shoots. Missed on the short side. Rebound. Vandon. On the far side by Hayduk. Kept in play by Leopold. Avs defenseman Jordan Leopold dumped it behind the net. Good start for this particular line, Peter. We saw really a carryover from what we saw a couple of nights ago in the game against the Nashville Predators.
Well, the coaching staff and the players to a man very upset with the start of last game. They've already spent more time in Chicago zone in the first 2 minutes of this game than they did in the first 10 minutes of that last game.
Just in front of the Chicago bench, the puck is shot in by Leopold. Hawks will get a hold of it. Moved up the near side boards, tipped out towards center. This Chicago Blackhawks.
No!
Two-game winning streak. And have they been hot of late? The only team that's been able to beat them lately has been the Detroit Red Wings. Into the corner, the puck behind the net for Jonathan Toews. Third youngest captain in the history of the National Hockey League. And a puck ahead for the Avalanche. Shot in, McLeod after it, but Javi Bulin, who has won both of his starts against the Avs this season, had stopped it, rolled back behind the net. Toews after it, chopped away from him. Chicago gets the puck back. And the Hawks will try to settle things down. We played nearly 3 minutes on our all-access night here at the Pepsi Center with Peter McNabb down between the benches, between Chicago and the Colorado's bench, and he'll be spending the entire game there. We'll have some interviews with Avalanche players and coaches through the game and get a chance to really get a different look at tonight's game as the Avalanche are hosting the Chicago Blackhawks. Tucker to center ice. Shot in, it gets tipped. Guilty for the Avs after it. One-handed back behind the net by Matt Walker, Chicago. Around to the far wing, tied up in the far side. It's been a good start for the Avalanche. Been spending some time in the Chicago zone, working hard. Tony Granato said the last 2 periods that they played against Nashville, the best 2 defensive periods, Peter, that they played in a row all season long.
And you want to build off that. But just on the offensive side of the puck, Jordan Leopold again. Let's not forget the Avalanche. The last 13 goals they've scored, Mike, defensemen have been in on 12 of them. That has to continue against a high-scoring club like Chicago. Chicago is going to score goals. You have to stay with them. You have to match them offensively.
They lead the NHL 3.68 goals a game. I mean, this is a team that has had 6 different games, Peter, with 6 goals scored for them. One of them against the Avalanche.
And one of the big keys, the defensemen make great first passes to players that can really skate.
Here comes Havlat, and he can make some moves. He put in front, and Raycroft makes the save. Real first time that Raycroft was tested. Well, we've told you a little about the goaltenders. Let's go behind the numbers on them as we give this to you, brought to you by Oppenheimer Funds.
Well, how's this for a number? Nikolai Habibulin lost his first game of the season, game 2 for the Blackhawks, lost once since then. And for Andrew Raycroft, he's lost once all season, 7-1 this year for the Colorado Avalanche.
You know, Peter, lately, though, it has been Cristobal Huey, who has made 11 of the last 17 starts for the Chicago Blackhawks team, but Hobby Bullen is 2-0 against the Avs.
Yeah, and for it's a wonderful situation. Both goaltenders playing well. I mean, the whole club. You can't find anyone that isn't playing well right now for the Blackhawks.
And are they happy they get Kane back in the lineup, right?
Are we happy?
Kane shot, and he found it off the glass. Bounced back behind the net. I saw the head coach of the Chicago Blackhawks, former Avalanche coach, Joe Quenneville, this morning. He said, 50-50 chance that Kane plays. Well, he is in the lineup. Shot from the point. He gets slowed down. Kane with a chance. It was tipped by Brett Clark. He just looked back at it in time, Peter, to see that shot going, and he tipped it.
Yeah, that was interesting. That's Brett Clark at his best. He was able to find that puck. He saw that Kane had the shot, and he just went down and blocked at a great angle. You see, Clark will turn. He loses it, and he just goes down. He allows, again, Raycroft to know that he is going to block the puck. The goaltenders have great confidence that once Clark goes down, he's going to block that puck.
And, Peter, how about the Avalanche with the injuries to Adam Foote and also Ian LaPerriere, who are normally alternate captains for this team? They're giving some other players a chance, and Brett Clark has got the A on tonight.
Yeah, but as far as the injuries go, I'm not sure that's you want to win that thing.
It's a jinx, isn't it? Knocked down in front, loose puck, Smith gets go!
They're
going to
win.
No, now they're waving it off. Indeed, at least initially, the referee is saying no goal, that it was kicked in. Tonight's referees are Wes McCauley and Ian Walsh. And after the puck went into the back of the net, Peter, we saw immediately the hands being waved by referee Ian Walsh saying no goal.
Let's watch this again. The puck comes across. You know, from that angle, it is tough to say that Smith deliberately kicks the puck in. So, no, I got to tell you that looked more of a continuation of a stride for Smith than an actual kick into the net. But the referee was right there.
Well, he reached back after it went off his leg, Peter. He did reach for the stick, but he didn't touch it, though, did he?
I don't believe he touched it. Had he touched it, then, of course, that's a good goal.
Right. So the review is happening right now. In Toronto, they're looking as to whether or not this will count as the first goal of the game.
When you're watching it right here, watch Smith. Is there, I mean, he does look down and find the puck, but does he kick it in deliberately? That is a tough read for me to say that he was able to right there, puck bounce down, and then have him kick it into the net.
But boy, I tell you what, Ian Walsh, the referee, Peter, had a really good, clear look at it, and he was pretty definitive in the way that he was calling that off, and he did so right away.
Now, because there's always that moment as a player kicking the puck to his stick, and the puck goes in.
Did you say that? Yes.
But it just has to be a deliberate kicking motion.
Into the net, though. I mean, it's one of those really, really tough calls to make on either side. This one's one of those ones that's right down the middle.
And plus, Peter, because Ian Walsh said no goal,
yes,
now it has to be overruled, right?
There has to be one right there. See, that seemed to... Now, Ryan Smith is a great athlete, but the ability for the puck to bounce off his left leg and then his right leg, that's a pretty... That's tough to do. But it's happening so fast down there. The referees are just right there on top of it. As you said, the referee is right there.
And again, because he waved it off, then the folks in Toronto have to really make a determination to overrule that referee's call on the ice. And this has taken a while. It's obviously not an easy decision being made in Toronto as to whether or not it was kicked in, deliberately kicking the puck in. I mean, I think it was very clear it did go off his leg, and his leg was moving forward. And there you see, that is Ian Walsh, the referee. Here's the signal, and...
After review of the play, it was determined there was no kicking motion. It's a good goal.
How about that? It gets overruled, and it is a goal for Ryan Smith, his 13th of the season, and the Avalanche, so important against the Chicago Blackhawks team, get the first goal of the game.
Well, this line, remember, couple games ago, when Volsky was moved to center, it was Hajduk was on the left side. Well, since that time, they've moved Smith back to the natural position on the left side. Volsky in middle, Hajduk on the right side, and they've had two very solid shifts. That goal was created by good forechecking for the Avalanche.
But 1-0 for the Avs. And it comes here in the first period of play. And Colorado up 1-0. Our first scoring summary. We'll show you that Ryan Smith now has a Baker's dozen this season, coming at 5-10. The lone assist to Wojtek Volsky. So Volsky keeps his hot streak going. And the Avalanche are up 1-0 over Chicago. But this is a Hawks team that can score goals. Dumped in, Raycroft will play it around the boards. Picked up by Hannon, out to center. And the pass gets tipped by Taves back into the Colorado zone. After it, Chicago defenseman Aaron Johnson. The Avalanche player goes down behind the net. Darcy Tucker, the Hawks trying to move the puck through the center zone. Brought down the far wing towards the corner. And after the corner is Verstig. He is on a three-game goal-scoring streak. His Verstig has been really a true star this year for the Hawks with 33 points.
Yeah, I mean, Verstig, and again, you look at the Chicago club, and we'll talk about how it was built all night long. But you get little breaks. Verstig is a player for Boston that was in a trade.
Sharp shot gets blocked. He's talking about having a good year. Patrick Sharp with 20 goals already this season for the Hawks.
And the thing about it is, Mike, no player in the Western Conference has more goals than his 20 goals, he and Erickson.
And around the boards, far wing, facing it for the Avs, Wilsey, and it goes off of Kane's stick. And out towards center ice, and Patrick Kane will slide it across. Matt Walker up ice for Sharp, leads Kane in over the line. Kane stops, centers into the slot. The Avs defensively were there. The shot by Sharp missed, and the rebound off the backboards, grabbed and snagged by Lyles. Gets it up ice for Spano. Over to Arneson, centers in front. It got tipped by a Hawk and goes off of Javi Bull, and the puck's still free. Kane's got it for Chicago. Sends it to center ice, racing after it down the far side. And getting to it, Ben Eager, number 55 for Chicago. Stopped by Raycroft. He tapped it back behind the net. Up ice for Ryan Smith, who's got the goal in this first period. The Avalanche leading it 1-0.
Mike, you see a lot of it, but we're seeing an intensity to it tonight. Matching lines. Both clubs are looking for the lineup matches that they want.
Volsky will shoot the puck around the boards in the Chicago zone. Stopped with a skate by Smith. Knocked away from him. Grabbed along the far wing. Flipped out towards center ice. The Avalanche defensively make the steal. Volsky down the near wing. Send in front with a backhand by Hajduk, who is headed to the All-Star game for the third time in his career. He's going to be the lone representative for the Avalanche going to the All-Star game. The Hawks will have three starters. Flipped out to center. Avalanche get it back. Daniel Sharnquist still in the lineup for the Avalanche. With the injury situation, Adam Foote still out on the injured reserve. And Ian LaPerriere not able to play. He did not skate this morning because of a back injury. The healthy scratches are Ben Gitte and Kyle Komiski for Colorado. Shot from center ice by Havlat. Circles the boards around the wing. Krzyzewski keeps it alive for a moment for Chicago. Then a steal by Stewart. Angles it across the middle zone. And Chicago will get it back.
It was a nice read by John Michael Lyles right there. The pass was just a little in front of him. Remember, he's the defenseman. He didn't take that chance. If he gets burned on that play, then all of a sudden there's going to be a quick turnaround.
This is going to be an icing call on Chicago. It was touched just in time. And this is all access night here at the Pepsi Center. And Peter McNabb is down between the benches.
Hey, Michael, hi. Just want to show you, a lot of times I've been asked by a lot of people, I think we've done it before, what do the players do? These are little ammonia capsules, and I'm going to, oh boy, I'll tell you, this gives you a little bit of that extra pep before you go on the ice. Hi, Mike, I'm ready to talk, I'll tell you.
On the draw, the Avalanche put it around the boards behind the net. Boland's got it for Chicago. Round, and Sharnquist could not hold it in. It's down the ice. Raycroft will set it for Leopold. Under 11 minutes to play, first period. This first period is moving along, I'll tell you. The Avalanche have scored a goal. Ryan Smith from Wojtek Volsky at 5-10. Not many whistles in this one. It's a line to dump it into the far side corner. Bobby Bullen allows the puck to be picked up by Matt Walker, the Chicago defenseman. Moves out towards center ice. Going to chip it ahead. They have to do a good job of preventing Chicago getting in. I think, Peter, what we've seen so far in the first 9 minutes and 40 seconds, the Avs have continued that good defensive play that we saw against Nashville a couple of nights ago. They're really not letting Chicago get much going offensively. And they also have a goal. Ryan Smith has scored his 13th of the season. And Colorado has a 1-0 lead over Chicago.
We're now into game three of this. I don't think it's going to be a short experiment for the Avalanche. Pavelski at center ice. And last game, Mike, again, I get back to the idea of his play without the puck. That's such a key. And especially when you're at center playing with someone like Milane, who, when he gets the puck, is looking for you to get open. And Volsky's done a great job in these three games.
Peter, I don't know if you got a chance to listen. I talked to Wojtek Volsky on the bench just before the game started. I said, well, why does this suit you so well? Hey, and you know what you think sometimes young players are going to say? Well, you know, I'm just happy to have a chance to play. He said, you know what? This is my position. I like the openness of it. I don't like being on the wing where you don't have much chance to create. I mean, he is really thriving right now in this position.
And Mike, you know, you and I have watched the three games. There's a body language change. There's no question about it. He just seems to have said, you know what? This, I'm going to show him that I can be that center that supposedly that you're looking for down the future. He's a man. He's 22 years old, and he has learned to play good defensive hockey. Let's not forget that he kills a lot of penalties for the Avalanche.
And we saw him outstanding job against the Nashville Predators doing exactly that, killing some penalties. The center ice comes Tyler Arneson, a former Chicago Blackhawk, ahead for McLeod. Top of the circle, his shot gets blocked. The side of the net into the corner. Arneson trying to keep it alive. Arneson, Spanos, and McLeod. A line out for the Avalanche. A pass to center ice for Chicago. Bowen will bring it in to the far wing. Picked up by Duncan Keith, the outstanding defenseman for Chicago. To Eager. Eager with it out of the corner. 1-0 lead for the Avalanche. Ryan Smith on a goal. And at first was disallowed by the referee and then overturned by the folks back in Toronto after it was reviewed. And the Avs lead this one 1-0. Hooked in by McLeod, cut off. Volsky, though, will snatch that away. Plays it behind the net for Hayden. Back to the corner. Volsky hands it off. Smith trying to center. And a block by Sharp of Chicago. Volsky reaches for it. He's got it. Lost it back to Sharp. Banked it off the boards. Flipped out towards center ice. Wisniewski through center with the puck. Into the Colorado zone. Gliding to his right. It's a soft shot off that gets blocked and taken back to center ice by Scott Hannon. Past the red line. He'll shoot it in. And it comes back behind the net. It is 1-0 in favor of the Avs with 8:30 to go in the first period of play. Through center ice, Dustin Byfuglien shoots it around the board. Into the corner. A hard hit sends Soleil down to the ice for Colorado. Back around the near side. Walker's shot. Pinballing around. Avalanche trying to clear. Volsky's got it out towards center ice. And on the move comes David Jones. Breaking down the near side wing to the corner. And Walker able to slay him, knock him down, the puck around the boards. Chicago's got it again. Flip back behind the net. It'll be taken by Aaron Johnson. Finds Walker on a bounce, flipped it back off the skate of Johnson to Walker. The Avs continue to put that pressure on. How about this forechecking pressure, Peter?
Yeah, but the Avalanche have just come out here tonight, and as you said, it's a continuation of work so well against Nashville. It's just hard work, and players getting back quickly into the right spots in the defensive zone.
That puck shot by Clark gets tipped into the Colorado bench and out of play. Beautiful Denver, 1-0 for the Avs. As part of our Burt Ford All Access night, Peter McNabb gets a chance to talk to the Avs head coach, Tony Granato.
You talk so much about the idea last 40 minutes of the game against Nashville, you played well defensively. Is that continuing tonight?
You know, it's been a good start, and obviously, you know, their team is based on speed. Their team is based on D that can join the play. So it's real important for us that we play well without the puck, and we take away the middle of the ice. And so far, it's been good. I like the way we're skating. I think all four lines have contributed either physically or being smart with puck decisions. So it's been a good start for us.
Tony, thanks so much, as usual.
Thank you, Davis.
Get our thanks to Tony Granato. And the ability to be able to talk to him during a course of game, being brought to you by Burt Ford. All access night, the Avalanche and the Chicago Blackhawks. And a big strike for Colorado, as Tony Granato pointed out. The team has played well defensively, and they have the first goal of the game. And Ryan Smith getting it at 5-10 here in this first period of play. And they have not allowed the Chicago Blackhawks many good scoring chances during this first period of play. And this is a team, the Hawks, that can score goals.
And that's just been interesting. Every hit that the Avalanche have had has been met with a real enthusiastic, you know, approach on the bench. Every single guy's getting a hit. We're talking about him. He's talking to him when he gets to the bench.
And the other thing, Peter, the other smart thing the Avs are doing in this game, while they are hitting, they aren't taking penalties. Campbell, who is going to the All-Star game for Chicago. Hamlet, his pass across and center for Bolas skipped away, and the Avs are on the move. It is Henze cutting in, and he used his speed. Turns towards the board, turns, fires at the front, kicked away by Hobby Boland, the Chicago Blackhawk goaltender. Lifted through center ice, back in to the Colorado end. It will be icing on Chicago. Well, why don't we take a look at tonight's key to the game, and it's brought to you by GMC Trucks.
To me, the key to tonight's game really was barrier chances. This is Chicago Blackhawk club that scores goals. They have a lot of players right now with great confidence. Great confidence. They're going to put the puck in there. The Avalanche have to match that confidence offensively.
Stewart on a bouncing puck, able to field it across. Clark keeps it alive. Hensick able to shovel it behind the Chicago net. Spun around by Brent Seabrook. Going to get it out, and it is tipped into the center circle. But here again, the Avalanche. And Peter, Tony mentioned it during your interview. They're really trying to clog the middle a little bit, not allow Chicago to use their speed through the neutral zone. And there was a great example of it.
And plus, the defense are not sitting back. They're right up close to the players.
Avalanche, again, smart defensively. Chicago could not get deep down the slot. Ryan Smith muscles his way in front. Backhand save. Another save by Hobby Boulin on Volsky. Wojtek Volsky had two stabs at it, but could not get it by Wojtek Volsky. Once again, this top line for the Avs creating some chances. The Avs lead in the first.
Michael, it's one of those situations, you like to have it or do you? Is it going to at some point during the season become a problem for the Blackhawks that they have two such accomplished goaltenders? Cristobal Huet and of course Hobby Boulin, who led Tampa Bay to a Stanley Cup. So at some point, do you have to pick one or the other, or can you go with both?
Well, Huet has started until tonight, 11 of the last 17 games. Boy, is it a situation, you and I have talked about this, is it a situation where you wait and then you feel like, well, we need to make one big trade of the trading deadline, and we know we've got this goaltending asset?
Yeah, absolutely. And I always get back to Chico Rush and Billy Smith with the New York Islanders. It was Chico Rush the first year that was the number one goaltender until the end, and then Billy Smith took over, and it was sort of history after that.
It's one thing to get through the season. It's also, Peter, who do you think, as a coach, as the management, who's our better goaltender come playoff time?
Who's got 16 wins in him?
Yeah, and there is one guy, and he's playing tonight. At center ice, Jonathan Toews over the line. Bufflin shoots, and it was going wide a bit, and Andrew Raycroft. And speaking of goaltending, let's talk about Andrew Raycroft.
Well, we're talking about Andrew Raycroft as I'm watching the training staff work on TJ Hensick, who just lost a tooth sitting here. He got bumped in the corner.
Which tooth is it?
Well, believe it or not, it's actually stuck in his mouth guard.
Yeah. The top one?
Yeah. One of those ones he's going to want next year for Christmas.
Oh, boy. At the center ice, Toews with the puck. Brought back in by Buckler. He shoots, knocked down, loose puck in front. Dropped off of Arneson's stick for a moment, comes back around. Johnson behind the net, centered out in front. It's cleared away by Hannon with a little launch down the center ice. Lucy's got the puck. Now, he's just not going to the locker room, is he, Peter?
No,
he just spit out the tooth and I'll play the next shift.
He gave it to Matt and he's out there right now. Well, the good thing, Mike, was only the top half of the tooth. So,
The top half or the bottom half of the tooth?
Oh, the bottom part.
Yeah, I was going to say. That'd be a little tough to do.
That would be interesting.
Yeah. So he lost half a tooth.
Half a tooth.
All right. You can play with that. That's no problem.
You still stay your ethos.
Saybrook with the puck for Chicago. Out to center ice. Brought in. Clark with it. Hands it off. Volski down the slot. And it did not get through. Almost threaded through some legs to an Avalanche. Bounce to center ice. Back into the Colorado zone. John Michael Wilde with it. Up ice. Ryan Smith. Wine shoots. And deflected wide by Nikolai Habibulin, the Chicago goaltender. Plucker along the near side of the half-board. Could not fire by Lyles. Lyles doing his best to keep it in the Chicago zone, and he does a good job. Smith over towards Wilsey. He gets bumped by Keith. And the puck grabbed and taken out towards center ice. Adam Burrish after the corner. This is a tough customer for the Chicago Blackhawks. Leopold's got a good hold on him in the corner. This game has moved along in the first period. We have not had a penalty call during this first period of play.
We've also had some great first passes by the defenseman.
Second chance by Burst, and that is blocked and then cleared away. And it comes all the way down the ice, and Brian Campbell will come back for the touch. That is an icing call on the Colorado Avalanche. Peter McNabb on Burt Ford All Access tonight between the benches. You still got all your teeth, right?
Well, I hope so. I'll be watching pretty close. You know, to me, what's been interesting, the Avalanche, the confidence they've had defensively. Remember, this is the number one offensive club in the NHL. They're coming off a 6-0 win against Phoenix, where they absolutely dominated Phoenix, and the Avalanche has done a great job early in this first period and into the later part of the first period, so it hasn't dropped off at all.
The Chicago team, Peter, as you know, they've won the last two. The other team they beat was another good team in the Calgary Flames. And in fact, this Hawks team, just two losses in the last 13 games they played, both to Detroit in back-to-back games. That's it.
Yeah, that was it. The end of the game right before the New Year's game, 4-0 in Detroit, and then the 6-4 loss in the big game of Wrigley. But that's since December 1st. That's it. Those are the only losses.
How about that? I mean, it's incredible. You think about it, how long this franchise has been around, and they've already set a record, franchise record, 9 wins in a row this season. That's a franchise record. Think how long this club's been.
Exactly.
In the NHL.
This is not one of those clubs that's, you know, 3 or 4 or 6 years into expansion. This is one of the original 6 clubs. It was long before the 6 clubs were called the original 6.
Just a moment ago, we saw everybody in the Avalanche bench ducking, getting out of the way. And Peter, you didn't seem to move too much.
Nah. I was frozen.
Scared?
Scared.
From the point, Johnson's shot and missed. Around the boards, Wisniewski keeps it alive. And around to the far wing, Strong Baffert. Got it for Chicago into the slot for Kane. The Avs have kept the dangerous Hawks at bay. Sharp, Kane, Taze, not much happening here in this first period. You can lease a new Lexus RX 350 for a great price. You can see Cooney Lexus on Broadway at Lexus of Colorado Springs. Great values, great cars.
Well, here's a play along the board. Remember, this is Bufflin, who has been probably Chicago's best player over the course of the first couple games against the Avalanche. And I'll tell you one thing I'm not getting involved in right now is a conversation between a few of these players. I'm backing right off, Michael.
Things getting a little angry down there?
Oh, yeah.
Off the draw, the puck picked up. Schoenquist has got it. Very out to center ice. Bouncing in the slot and then poked away. Peter, when the anger starts going, what is that coming from? Is it hits on the ice? Is it just frustration? What leads to it?
It's just part of hockey. If you felt that one guy took a little bit of a long run of one of the players for the Avalanche, the Avalanche step out and say, no, that is going to happen. And the Blackhawks, who are a good, tough team themselves, going to back it up.
Shot in. Keith will pick up. Turns, twists, and there you see a really nice-looking play from Duncan Keith. Into the cross for Seabrook.
He's the most underrated player in the NHL right now, Mike.
You could make a case. I mean, they've already got 3 guys starting in the All-Star game. You could make a case for Duncan Keith as well. Oh. New center ice, Wolfie coming in. Offside on the Colorado Avalanche. Well, we talked already, Peter, about how many goals the Chicago Blackhawks team scores on average.
And this is the elite of the elite of the elite in the NHL right now, these clubs. And that is why this first period has been so impressive for the Avalanche. They've had now 10 shots on goal. But I don't think they've had 3 scoring chances if they've had that in this first period. So Again, the Avalanche doing a good job. Team defense. Every single guy seems to be really working at being in the right spot at the right time.
Not only, Peter, Chicago scoring a lot of goals, they're the fourth best defensive team in the National Hockey League as well. So that was a very, very good period for Colorado.
You know, you could just tell right off the bat that there was an intensity for the Avalanche. You come out here and you play a sloppy first period against a team like Chicago, they'll do what they did to Phoenix last game, where it was 4-0 at the end of the first period, and they, you know, the game was basically over.
But no, not tonight. The Avalanche with a strong first period, and after one, they lead 1-0. Watching NHL hockey on your home of the Avs, Altitude Sports and Entertainment. After the break, please stay tuned. We'll have the Toyota Intermission Report. The Avalanche and the Chicago Blackhawks have played a period of hockey at the Pepsi Center, and the Avalanche, with a goal from Ryan Smith, lead 1-0. I think that first period story, Peter, was really about how hard the Avalanche worked. All three zones, they got good goaltending, and really was about hard work, wasn't it?
Very quickly, the Chicago Blackhawks have become one of those clubs you have to respect. The Avalanche came out there and showed the right combination of confidence and respect. And I thought the first period, look at the rookie Stewart right here, back and forth, just basically hems the puck in for about 15, 20 seconds and gives his players time to set up defensively. Chicago doesn't have one of those quick breaks. Andrew Raycraft, solid in net for the Avalanche. And then watch, all five players in red are back. There's three players in white, Blackhawk, all five, the players for the Avalanche back. And for Andrew Raycraft and Mike, just another solid period in nets.
And Ryan Smith has the only goal in this game so far. And the Avalanche have a 1-0 lead. On the draw, the puck picked up by the Avs, carried through center. Spinos played off the boards. Chipped ahead. That gets blocked at the Chicago line. And squirts across to the near wing. Campbell fired up the boards and slipped in down the near side. And behind the net, Lyles will hand it off to Brent Clark. Looking to make a pass, he cuts across, puts it right on the tape for Spinos. He shoots and off the glove of Javi Bullen. Patrick Kane will take it away. Up off the boards. Sharp has got it with Campbell and Eager. And the pass towards Eager slipped past him. Tipped up the slot to center ice, and the Avalanche have got it. Moving through center ice, Spinos dropped it. Arneson shot off a body into the corner, and we will have our first penalty of the game, and it goes against the Chicago Blackhawks.
Well, Eager goes off in the first power play for the Avalanche.
Number 55, Chicago, 2 minutes. Hooking.
You know, Mike, one of the real interesting things about hockey, and it just wasn't the way it is now for such a long time, is teams will adjust during the intermissions. They will change strategy. They will change matchups. And it's going to be interesting to see how both of these clubs attack the second period. It may be different from how they attack the first.
Chicago with the puck.
Chicago penalty.
Clear down the ice. So Eager off, looking at 48 seconds of the period. The Avalanche have not scored a power play goal against Chicago this season. 0-8. With a man advantage. Volsky down the slot. Rolled away. Kicked out by Javi Bullen. Right around into the corner. From behind the net. Hajduk with the puck. Dropped it there. The hands of Hajduk, Volsky, Smith out on this power play. Hajduk with the puck. And back on the points, it's Soleil and Leopold. Soleil lost the puck and just reached back in time to poke it away.
Good strong play by Soleil, because the Blackhawks were gone on a 2-on-1.
Volsky off the board, Smith with it. Shoots it and then lost it. Back in the other way by Ladd into the Colorado zone. 1 minute remaining in Eager's penalty. Picked up, Ladd moving in, but Lyles has got an angle. The shot off the arm of Ray dropped into the corner. Stewart picks up, carries to center ice, past the red line. In down the far side, dropped it off. Henson curling to the far wing. Back to the point. Lyles with a shot. That was a laser. Stopped by Javi Bullen. Turned over. Shot tip and a pad save. And a nice one by Javi Bullen. Back behind the net. Henson to the far wing. Bottles to the point. Lyles with another try. Stick save by Javi Bullen. Up the far wing. Back again to Lyles. He winds. He shoots. And that one was tipped wide. And the Avalanche keep it alive in the Chicago zone. to the far circle, tipped up the far wing. There's Lyles again. The pass ricocheted to the front, to the near side point. Clark over to Lyles. He's had three shots on this power play. Clark with a chance, tipped on net, and Avi Bulin looking around, but he does have it on that redirection by T.J. Henson.
Well, I'll tell you, Mike, it was evident. It was right there for the Avalanche. Every time the puck went back to the point, everything was geared toward getting the puck on net. Avi Bulin, nice save on T.J. Henson right here. Here's Clark Henson again in front. A little tip, and that's the one that Avi Bulin did a nice job of moving out. Got no idea where that tip is going to go, but he moved out in a big body in front of that puck.
Into the corner. The five shots for the Avs on that power play. I mean, they really had some chances. John Michael Lyles with three of them from the point. Broken up at center ice. Another good defensive play by the Avs. Hit at center ice by Keith. That puck will pop up and go across and over the glass and out of play. So we've had 3 minutes played in the second period. 1-0 for Colorado.
And for the Chicago Blackhawks, Jonathan Toews, Mike, what a, this is his 102nd game in the NHL. And you look at what it's been, a whirlwind of first 102 games. Calder Cup finalist last year, Patrick Kane won it. He's been the captain of this hockey club at 20 years old, third youngest ever in the history of the National Hockey, not just the Blackhawks. He plays in the Wrigley Field game. He's chosen to the All-Star game, Michael. And, I mean, by the fans, he's going to be a starter. And he's 20 years old. He doesn't turn 21 until April 28th. That's a lot to keep, you know, in perspective.
It really is.
I can't even tell you at 21 or 20 what I would have been doing at any one of those things.
Bouncing Buck Campbell. And he's going to the All-Star game for the Chicago Blackhawks. And off the side, shot by Wilsey, and he missed it. Campbell tried to put it around behind the net and just kind of caromed off the side of the Chicago net and gave Wilsey a good chance. Loose puck behind the net. Hannon's got it out of the corner.
Like, it might look like luck, but that's out of hard work.
Coming back for the puck and behind the net. Smith makes the steal, centers, but it was picked off. Hanzik was darting to the front. Campbell carries in, coming wide, shoots it off the end boards and behind the net. Waved at by Sharnquist, trying to clear. Backhands it, high around, knocked down, shot right on target, but Ray Crosswood's ready. Shot by Bull, another save, that's squirts free. There'll be a penalty. It's going to be against the Avalanche. Delay call. Avi Bulin on his way to the bench. Keith looking, looking now. Shoots, and that skimmed and then hit the netting and is out of play. But the Avalanche will be shorthanded for the first time.
Well, the Avalanche have not been sloppy in their own zone too often. But right here, one of the first times they just cough up the puck, and all of a sudden the Blackhawks, who you cannot give many chances to, because we talked about the number of players that have the ability to put that puck in, is about as good, Mike, as any club in the league. They have great depth as far as guys that have confidence with that puck.
So Jordan Leopold in the box for hooking at 4:34. And the Chicago Blackhawks, while they have beaten the Avalanche twice this season, they only have one power play goal in the two games against the Avalanche. 1-for-8 this season. Patrick Sharp sends it across, and Wojtek Polski. I've been really impressed, Peter. I know you have too, with his penalty kill.
It's just, and this is why, one of the reasons why the Avalanche will stay with him at center ice, his defensive ability. He's showing you why offensively, but he's doing a good job defensively.
Shoot it.
Shot, score, and this game is tied at one. The power play goal for the Chicago Blackhawks has tied it up. Well, we knew they were a dangerous bunch, and the Chicago Blackhawks, who can score goals, have tied this one at one. Brian Campbell.
Well, Brian Campbell started last year with Buffalo. Buffalo couldn't sign him, goes to San Jose. San Jose thought they were going to sign him. He doesn't sign with them. He signs then with the Chicago Blackhawks. A huge deal in the summer. Now, does Toews 19 in front get a piece of this? No, I think it goes right past. But Campbell, I had a great look at that. Campbell walked around just along the blue line, then took a couple steps in. Toews in front. And now for the Blackhawks, as you mentioned, the power play goal. But they've been, Mike, maybe not good against the Avalanche this year. But overall, the fifth best power play in the National Hockey League. That's their 40th this season.
Fifth overall, fifth best on the road of any NHL team. And for Brian Campbell, his fourth power play goal of the season. And this one is tied up at one. That was only the second penalty called in this game. There's been one against each team, both coming here in the second period. And behind the net, the puck is grabbed, wraparound try, gets stopped. Let's take a look at our Geico scoring summary. And it is Campbell with his seventh of the season, fourth power play goal at 5:16, and Patrick Kane now with 42 points Peter this season. That's 26 assists for Patrick Kane.
Yeah, he is. There's actually a very interesting story about some of the luck you need if you're going to be a good hockey club.
Shot in high by Hinze, and it comes around to the far wing. Wisniewski, long pass to center. Johnson will dump in on Raycroft. And the Avalanche will take it. Delay, long pass ahead. Smith waits. Nice pass in the slot. Boski with a bullet! And it hit the glass. Cams around the boards. Shot by Hannon. Missed on the short side. Around to the far wing. Delay with a chance. That gets stopped. And the Hawks have got it. To center ice, Havlin. With Ladd. Long shot steered away. And into the far corner. Plays behind, shot by Bolin, missed. Around to the near wing. Pass goes out of the zone. And Zebras got to send it back into the Chicago end. And across, deflected. Soleil shoots it ahead. Pass near wing. Keith has got it. Long pass right at the Avalanche line, but coming back defensively. Lyles broke things up for Colorado. Bounced out to center ice. Pass picked off. Avalanche have got it. Arneson, nice pass. In shot, missed by McLeod. And around the boards, eager long pass. This game is opening up, folks. Here comes Kane. Shot, he missed it. And around to the near side boards. Here's my imagination is just going back and forth with great chances.
Yeah, and the players with the puck again. Kane right there on the off wing, just looking to try and find something that's open.
Grabbed by Sharp. Rounds tipped out to center ice. Side of the net. Javi Bourne. Back into behind Campbell. Play continuing on. This has been a game with very few whistles. Play has just continued. Only a couple of penalties. Two goals. One for each team.
But there's always one reason for not many whistles. It's good passing. Both clubs are passing the puck, getting open, getting to the center ice line and getting that puck in.
Back from center ice. It'll bounce off the side of the Avalanche. Wrapped around the boards. Up now towards center. It's tipped into the corner. Krasinski back for it. Whipped around the boards. Put back behind the net. Tucker scooped into the corner. Up the far wing, kept alive. Karam's out to center ice. Hawks trying to move it ahead. They do. Bob the line shoots. And that was a cannon that missed on the short side and flicked into the Chicago bench by Hanzik and out of play. The Avs scored in the first period, and the Chicago Blackhawks with a power play goal from Brian Campbell in the second period has tied this game at one.
Welcome back. All access continues here on Altitude. Chicago and Colorado tied at one. You know, you ever wonder what's going on here at the TV timeouts? You can see right here, it's the ice crew clearing up the snow, the loose snow. Now, it's a league mandate that they must do that. Everyone has their own ice crew, headed up by Tony Crush right here. They get all the high traffic areas, clear all the snow out of those areas in front of the benches and in front of the crease here. And to give you an idea how much snow that really is, this bucket right here in front of me, every single timeout, they'll fill up a quarter of that bucket, which Tony Crush says is about 10 pounds of snow. So in order to keep the game fast, they need to do this at every TV timeout. Mike?
Thanks very much, Kyle. Play has continued here during the second period. We do have a whistle with 10:50 remaining. It's a tie game 1-1. And on Burt Ford Access Night, All Access Night, there's Peter McNabb between the benches.
And Mike, I'll tell you the real reason. It's not to keep the game going fast. That's part of the reason. The real reason is that goaltenders used to build up a mountain of snow right beside the post. It was like passing through a snowbank. They would build up snow and build up snow. You can imagine if they didn't clear it away. One of the worst ever was Hall of Famer and his number retired for the Chicago Blackhawks, Tony Esposito. He would have a 6-inch bank built up. And I remember one playoff game. Terry O'Reilly went down during a TV timeout and took all the snow as Tony's watching and just pushed it away and sort of defied somebody to come over and stop him.
Loose puck in the high slot, kept in. Lyles hustles, he shoots, and the glove save made by Hobby Bullen. If you're the Avalanche coaching staff here, you got to love the fact that Lyles is getting some shots here.
And you know, you're getting them because you're looking for them. That is the big key for in any situation offensively. You have to be ready when the opportunity is there. This game is just so fast. Everything is happening just as quick as you can imagine. If you're getting that puck and going, huh, I wonder what I'm going to do. No, nothing's going to happen. Great play by Lyles.
Bounce around the boards, near wing. Picked up, carried out towards center ice. Rammed around to the far wing. Slap. And it got tipped into the screen, and so the puck is out of play. This game tied up at one in the second period. It has been an intense game.
And, Mike, we're talking about Patrick Kane, just how well he has played. He's going to the All-Star game, and well, he should. But you talk about those little things that can make a franchise. 2007 draft. The Chicago actually had the fourth pick. They won the lottery. They won the ping pong ball that gave them the first pick. They moved up three spots and took Patrick Kane. You know, you need those little breaks when franchises are trying to build their way back up.
Lifted down the ice. And then when you get those chances, Peter, you better take advantage of them. Huh? And Chicago Blackhawks did. It can be a franchise-changing pick, can it? And that's what's happened in Chicago.
Absolutely.
It's part of it.
Taves and Kane in back-to-back drafts.
Have a shot. Deflected. The side of the net. Volsky will play it off the board. Smith gets hit. The puck comes to center ice. Hayduk trying to get by. Keith, who played it well, flipped to center ice. Grabbed by Salone. Back in the round and behind the net. Keith will pick up. 9:15 to go. In the second. Game tied at one. Kane, far side circle for Chicago, waiting back towards the point. Lukowski kicks it across. Stopped by Johnson. Didn't have much on it. Slapped around by Spatos. Back to the point. And Johnson missed on the short side. Kept in by the Hawks. Down the boards. Up by Spatos. Lead pass to center for McLeod. Hit by Lukowski. Johnson back for it. Rifled around the boards.
I'm ready, time,
waiting.
Time.
Eager for Chicago to center. Sends it across the rink on a tip by Stewart. The puck was behind the Avalanche net. Clark after it along with Stewart. Off the boards. It's down the ice. Abs after it. Behind the Chicago net. Whipped around. Cut off by Clark. He was at the half boards. Towards the corner. Stewart left it there for Hensley. Little flip behind the net. Stewart's got it. Trying to hand it off. And Hensley still with it. Good work by Stewart and Hensley. Then poked away by the Hawks. Tipped out to center ice. A race for the puck. Bufflin picks it up. Bufflin walks in. Circles behind the Avalanche. Dead put it front. Oh, what a save! What a save by Redcross! Robbing the Hawks. It looked like a short goal. Back into the Chicago zone. Hobby Bullen will set it up. Oh, man. Save of the game for Andrew Redcross.
And not just a save on any Blackhawk. That's Patrick Sharp, their leading goal scorer, with 20.
Steal. Avalanche get it back. Handed. Flipped it down the ice. Back into the Chicago end. To the corner. Played up. Out towards center ice. Burst waits. Moves it with a backhand. Knocked down by Taves. Run at. Taves. Wouldn't hold on to that puck. Run the other way. By Dupuy. On the draw. Tucker. Curls to the corner. Put it behind the net for Dupuy. Far circle. Shot. Missed by Soleil. It's snuck down from the point. Puck up all the way down the ice. Cannon's got it up off the boards.
Like that really does look like it's going to be a key part to this game. There's good defensive pressure by both clubs down low. That defenseman jumping up is going to be a big factor.
Glad shot directed wide. Great cross. Shots in this game, 20 for the Hawks, 16 for the Avalanche. 1-to-1 contest. Smith in. And Hobby Bull let it kick away, but you can see that. Nice passing between to Smith and Hayduk as they move down the ice with not much room between them.
tell you though, Michael, Hattie Boone does not like to freeze that puck. There's been a half dozen times when he has a chance to freeze it, hasn't it moved the puck to the boards.
Coming down the slot, Hayden shot, looking for a tip from Smith that goes wide, cleared away. Peter, what does that say about a goaltender? Why is he doing that?
That's just his style. That's he likes to keep the play going, keeps the puck moving, likes to move it to his defenseman, get the puck out of the zone.
Going down the board, Spino Saptrick for the Avs. Lifts it up on a hot kick to head by McLeod. McLeod's got it. McLeod moving in. McLeod to the front of the net. Ring off and knocked wide by Wisniewski. McLeod still working hard for the puck. Punch to the boards near side in the Chicago zone. 6 minutes to play in the second period. Tied up at one. Smith in the first period for Colorado. And Campbell for Chicago on the power play in the second. Long shot. Knocked down by Ray Kroc, played around the inboards. McLeod after it, and a little support from Wiles. Flagged down, shot by Walker right on. Ray Kroc kicked it away. Johnson comes down. He turns, he shoots it through the crease to the wide. Walker stretch, gets it in, bends it down the far side wall for King. Stick handles back towards the blue line. Wine shoots, tipped down low, shot wide, no set, rebound set wide, and in the far side corner by Brower. Oh, man! Great save by Ray Kroc, and then the miss on the rebound. Campbell coming back. This crowd is buzzing right now at the Pepsi Center about the save by Andrew Ray Kroc.
The Avalanche bench are buzzing about too many men on the ice for the Blackhawks, but for Andrew Ray Kroc, who had already made one great save right here on Patrick Sharp. And now at the end of this shift, as the Blackhawks led by Kane, again, Sharp went to tuck it in. He dove back. Ray Kroc. I think for the Avalanche right now, because everyone is just, I mean, they are just gassed. They've been out for probably a minute, minute and 10 seconds. The Avalanche have taken this time to take their time out. Again, you just, Mike, you're just watching. We talked about at the top of the show, two really good skating clubs. And we're seeing the skating. Speed to me is generated through that neutral zone, and both of these clubs through the neutral zone have just really been flying. Yeah, more and more you're seeing the trap, that thing that just killed hockey for a while, go away. I mean, because the speed, the players are adjusting to it, the coaches are adjusting to it, the passing in the league is just getting better and better, and the trap is becoming less and less of a factor.
I know for you, Peter, I'll say the same thing. This is so much more fun to watch, isn't it? Right. This has been a fun, even though it's just one-to-one, both you and I love to watch a lot of goals, this has been a lot of fun to watch.
Oh, yeah, unless you like mud drying, I mean, it this is a much better game.
Sure is. Ray Kroc with a couple of key saves and keeping it a 1-1 game after the Hawks tied it here in the second period. Campbell has scored the goal, weaving his way through. Finds Sharp, has been robbed twice. Threw it towards the front, off the stick into the corner. Hanzik will get to it for Colorado. Sends it across the slot in his own zone. Clark turns it over towards Soleil. He gets through the middle circle, backhanded into the corner. Fisher will hop to the side of the net. Campbell going to chase it down, gets to it, fires it out to center. It was deflected. And Ray Kroc will slow it up for Soleil to take. Warren hands it up the boards for Jones. And he's able to thread it through Stewart into the Chicago zone, but he was preceded. And it is an offside play on the Colorado Avalanche. We are tied in the second period. Andrew Ray Kroc are getting ready. And just a moment ago, Peter McNabb talked with John Michael Lyles on the Avs bench.
John, just the pace seems to be great. Talking to us about this hockey game.
Well, yeah, I mean, you know, they're a very talented team, and you know, they bring a lot of energy to their game, and thus far we've been able to, you know, to match that. And we just got to keep up that pace and try to keep guys driving to the net and throwing pucks to the net, hopefully get another rebound here.
Johnny, thanks so much. Good luck.
One of the great things about our Burt Ford All-Access night, Peter McNabb with that access to the Avalanche players, and we certainly thank John Michael Lyles for being able to talk it during a little stoppage in play. Now, play is underway in the second period with the game tied at one, 4 minutes to go. Smith for the Avs, Campbell for the Hawks. Great saves from Andrew Raycroft, and a good pace to this game here in Denver, Colorado at the Pepsi Center. The Avs and the Hawks, been entertaining. Wilson shoots it to the corner. After it, Darcy Tucker. Puts in the corner, cut off by Taves, backhanded up the boards. The Avalanche continue to put some pressure on, but Taves frees up the puck for Bufflin. Centered back in front, stepped on. I think Taves stepped on the puck, did he, Peter?
It just seemed to fall. I'm not sure if he stepped on the puck, but again, Jonathan Taves, what a, I mean, this is what we're talking about, the interest in the Blackhawks. You got a line with Kane, and then you bring out Taves. And both of them offer very, very different styles, different ways of approaching the game. But you know, you're certainly an exciting club to watch.
Smith coming back for the puck. Cross ice pass intercepted at center. And Burstyn just knocked down the ice. Wojtek Bolski with the hit. At center, the Hawks get it again. Ladd over the line, but immediately surrounded. Havlet to the corner, centered out in front. And Peter, we've talked about all these guys, and almost lost in this is play that, I mean, I just admired through the years, Martin Havlet. You almost forget about him in a sense. And he's, I mean, he is such a thrilling player to me to watch.
Yeah, and the thing about him, this year he's played 37, this is 38th game. He only played 35 last year. So a healthy Havlet is gaining so much to this club down the road.
And with a cross to pick up the puck, John Michael Lyles, 2.5 minutes to go. In the middle, McLeod for the Avs, cuts in, the wrister, and the save by Javi Bullen, and then a little pressure from McLeod draws a crowd and some anger from Chicago. As they settle things down, we'll step aside for a moment. We'll be back to the Pepsi Center in a few, 1-1 in the second. Avalanche and the Hawks tied at 1, and Peter, we have an update on Joe Sakic's situation.
Yeah, it was just yesterday, I believe, the operation a couple days ago for Joe Sakic. Mike is scheduled to be out for 10 weeks. When does that take you to? If it was exactly 10 weeks, and that is a ridiculous thing to say, but if it was, it would take you to March 18th. If we passed the trade deadline of March 4th, the Avalanche would have, at that time, 7 home games, 4 on the road, 11 games remaining. Certainly enough time to have an impact with the Avalanche in the playoff picture.
Joe Sakic has been quoted saying he is expecting to come back, isn't it, Peter? And the club and the coaching staff expect that Joe Sakic is going to play again this season. Out of the corner, the puck picked up by McLeod. Little chip pass, return, McLeod to the bottles. McLeod will pick it up behind the net. There's going to be a penalty. And it's going against the Chicago Blackhawks. A little nice pass in front for Spatos. But he missed that one, but there was a penalty drawn. And the Avs are going on the power play.
Chicago, number 10, Meyer penalty flashing.
One of the things that I've always admired about Marek Svatos, he may not be the biggest guy, but when he gets his eye on the puck and where he wants to go, there is nobody, nobody is big enough to keep him from trying to get there. Right there, he just drove through to the front of that and just missed putting it top shelf.
So the power play goes to the Avs, their second of the game. They're 0-for-1 in this one and 0-for-9 this season against Chicago. They came into this game sixth best penalty killing team. The league off the post on a chance to the point by Ruslan Soy. Leopold's opportunity blocked and sent down the ice by Frazier. Frank Roth will set it. 1:20 to go in the period. 90 seconds remaining in Schrock's penalty. Avalanche on the power play, second period. Getting late in the second period. Chopped down by Leopold, but he's got to chase the puck back into the Colorado zone. Long pass ahead for Smith. Broken up at the line. Smith will take it in. He gets surrounded by Chicago players, and the puck slithers out to center. Less than a minute remaining in the period. Avs on the power play, 1-1 game. Spatos cutting across, back towards the point, but Jones was headed off the ice, and Lyles will chase it back into the Colorado zone. 30 seconds to go in the period. Lyles shots, and by my count, that is now 4 shots on the power play for John Michael Lyles in the 2 power plays tonight.
And that puck was sort of fluttering as Lyles hit it. Harry Boone would have to be sharp.
Center ice, poked away. Ladd brings it in. He shoots, save, loose puck. Overskated, then back in. Another stop in front. The puck comes free. Spatos has got it. A little help from the defense by the Avalanche to help out Andrew Raycroft. And there is the end of the period. Then a little pushing and shoving, and the tempers are flaring right at the end of the second period. That is really the kind of game this has been. It has been intense tonight.
Well, these are big points for both of these clubs, and it's like Brett Clark said, okay, get out of the way. I'll handle this one. I'll take He's just diving around. Raycroft and Clark come across. And
he's just dying to play goalie one night, isn't he?
Isn't he? Nah, both goalies go down. There is no question of who's going in.
All right, well, it has been entertaining. We've had two periods of play in Denver, and it is tied at one. You're watching the Avs on Altitude Sports and Entertainment. Coming up next, stay tuned. It'll be the Lexus Intermission Report. It has been a very fun game to watch so far through the first 40 minutes of play. Avs scored the first period. Chicago scored in the second period. And, Peter, the game has been very entertaining, but Chicago could have a nice lead if not for the effort of Andrew Raycroft and some defensemen as well.
Yeah, for Andrew Raycroft, he's won five in a row, 2.16 goals against average during those five games. And he has made the big save at the right time for the Avalanche. When you watch how he has played, he's very, very calm, very relaxed. Every time, Mike, that he's come over to the bench during the TV timeout, there's nothing to hint of panic, or he's talked to the defensemen about a couple of plays, but he's just been sharp again in nets for the Avalanche. He was good last game against Nashville. But there's the play I love. It looked like Brett Clark just kind of pushes him out of the way. I'll take this one. You've been busy enough for the night.
23 saves for Andrew Raycroft in this game. And here we go to the third period of play. And for Nikolai Haviboulin.
Yeah, the six goals have come in the third period. Both game-winning goals for Chicago have come in the third period. So this is a big period for the Avalanche. They had that history against these Blackhawks, and they want to, Mike, big 2 points here tonight.
The Avalanche came into the game with 41 points. The Blackhawks with 10 more points than the Avalanche. They've got 51 this season. They're second place in the Central Division, fourth overall in the conference. For the Avalanche, fifth in their division, 10th in the conference. But everybody's jam-packed. Loose puck down low. Bouncer to the point. Shot by Wisniewski. On target. Save made by Raycroft. That power play is now over for the Avalanche. They had one shot during that two-minute power play that carried over the end of it, at least did, into the third period of play. Kane works his way down the slot. His pass intercepted and brought the other direction by Ryan Smith. Broken up, carried in. Volsky down the slot. Volsky, poke checked away from him. Moves back towards the blue line. Bounces off the boards. And Karam's in to the near side circle. Dumped down the ice wide of Raycroft. It'll be an icing call on Chicago. Why don't we look ahead for the Avalanche and see what's on tap. This is being brought to you by Coors Light. On Saturday afternoon, the Avs are hosting the Young Guns of the Pittsburgh Penguins. You can catch all the action live with our special access show. Peter will be back between the benches and complete coverage beginning at 1 o'clock. Only on your home of the Avs, Altitude Sports and Entertainment.
And just today, the Pittsburgh Penguins announced that they have tied up Jordan Staal for four-year extension. Four-year contract, $16 million.
Havlat moves to the far face-off circle. Back to Havlat. It bounced off his stick and carried out to center ice. Of course, the real draw will be, Peter, and it's easy to say, Crosby and Malkin. And it's just going to be fun to watch them.
But they're struggling right now, Mike. They're losing in Nashville 5-3, and Nashville has not been scoring many goals.
The far side with it, Cannon. Tipped out to center ice. I think it's for Avalanche fans, you just know the way the NHL schedule is now. You don't know when Chicago will be back here in Denver.
Oh, absolutely.
Take advantage of either getting a ticket coming, or if you can't, we'll have the broadcast for you. Center ice brought in. Bolin winds, shoots, and Soleil came out and went off for the shaft of the stick and up into the screen and out of play.
Now here's a look at the night for Wojtek Volski. There's a good play on the penalty kill. A good charge to the net. His line with Hayduk and Smith has been the best offensively for the Avalanche. Good check right here in the neutral zone. And here the good forecheck gets that stick. He has a great stick, Mike, as far as getting that puck, intercepting passes. He chips it across. The Avalanche had that goal reviewed. It counted. He has an assist tonight, 3 points in two games.
Avalanche with possession. And we are in third period of play in Denver at the Pepsi Center. The Avalanche and the Chicago Blackhawks. Been a hard fought game. Very close, very tight. 27 shots for the Hawks, 20 for the Avalanche. Goals are even at one apiece. From behind the net, Ryan Smith centers. There's a chance. Followed up by Lyles. Knocked down. Smith couldn't get it on net. Keith will take it away for Chicago. Duncan Keith, the pass up ice. Havlet skates in over the line. Havlet lost the puck. Take it away. He was stripped by Smith. And make the pass that's taken back by the Hawks. Flipped across over the line. Rink wide. Havlet's got it for Chicago. Turns, shoots it through the crease and wide. And around the boards of the far wing. Lyles to center ice for Volsky. Trying to split through. And the puck comes to the corner. And Volsky turns and goes back towards the Avalanche bench.
And Mike, last game between these two clubs, tied at two. Wojtek Volsky scored a goal we thought was going to be the game winner on a great individual thrust and split the Chicago defense.
Knocked ahead and back into the Chicago zone. Twist it back. Johnson flips the puck to center. Sean Quartz has got it. Coming in down the slot. Defenseman Aaron Johnson could not move down the slot. And again, the Avs do a nice job of really preventing teams from the last two games, Nashville and now Chicago in this game, from getting in, setting up in the zone. We really, Peter, for the chances Chicago has had, they do have the power play goal. They really have not spent a ton of time in the Avalanche zone just kind of setting up and really just getting great scoring chances one after another, have they?
No, we haven't been talking about one play after another. Kane, then Taves, then Sharp. The Avalanche, across the board, has had a good game defensively.
Kane flips it through the circle. Over the line for Sharp, offside on the Chicago Blackhawks. You can lease a new Lexus RX 350 for a great price. You can see Cooney Lexus on Broadway and Lexus of Colorado Springs. There's great values and great cars.
Mike, as we're watching this game, 1-1. Blackhawks are used to scoring goals. Right now, they seem to be maybe a little more frustrated as they come to the bench as opposed to the Avalanche. You really have very single-minded in their approach this third period.
Arneson moves down the far side boards to the side of the net. And certainly, Peter, there's a long way to go here in this third period. And certainly the Avalanche would like to win things in regulation. But the one thing that the Avs have, more so than just about any other team in the NHL, is the belief that, you know what, if it's tied in the third period, that's fine. We believe in ourselves, come overtime or shootout situation.
Well, they should. 8-1 this season.
Yep. Tucker from behind the net. Dropped along the boards. Wilson off the back of the net to himself. Put it behind for Volsky. Goes out in front, centers. And taken away by the Hawks. Tipped out towards center ice.
Right, that was a great look. Tucker was open if that pass gets through.
It did. And the whistle has been blown. The play has stopped. Another good game from Wojtek Volsky. He's got an assist.
You can see, just see him every time that he's on the ice. He comes off the ice. He's talking with the wingers. In this situation, it was Tucker and Wilsey, but Heyduk and Smith, the conversation, he is talking every single time.
Seabrook shoots it across. Keith has got it. Forechecked by Stewart, the center for Bowen. He finds Havlet in front of the penalty boxes. He'll dump in again. The Avs are standing. There are all five players right on that blue line. And Chicago could not skate the puck in. That far side, Sean Kuznetsov backs it up the boards, lifted to center ice, smacked across. Winooski, the red line, slammed in around the boards, all the way down the ice into the Chicago zone. 14 minutes remaining. Third period. Smith, Campbell, the goal scorers. Game tied up at one.
Game's become a bit of a chess match down here as far as players, I mean, really conscious defensively, if not allowing the other team to have any odd man breaks.
Peter, has the bench has been shortened a little bit on either team?
Not for the Avalanche.
All four lines still going out. We'll be back in a moment. Heyduk headed to the All-Star game later. His team right now, tied with Chicago.
Well, Michael Milan-Hayduk going to what is going to be an unbelievable event in Montreal. The All-Star Game, you look at the names, and no question, there is that star value name factor going with some of these players going to the All-Star Game. But to me, what's the most exciting thing is I could pick a club, Mike, of another 21 players that are deserving from the Western Conference. You look at the guys that aren't going, and you are talking about some of the very best players in the game. It is a great time for hockey as far as the skill and the stars and the young players that have come into this league.
Peterson, Jackie Dunn with the National Hockey League, and it is not a rule that every team has to be represented, but it's kind of an unwritten rule.
Yep.
And so every team in the Eastern Conference and every team in the Western Conference represented in the All-Star Game. All right, let's go down to Kyle Keefe and take a look at the Eastern Conference All-Stars.
Yeah, guys, you just mentioned all those big names from the Western Conference. Eastern is just, I mean, it's almost as big or better. And you look at some of these guys, the defense for the Western Conference, what they're going to have to put up. Alexander Ovechkin, Jeff Carter, Vanek, LeCavalier, Kovalchuk, these aren't even starters. And Peter, like you just mentioned, maybe another name that could be thrown in there is Phil Kessel. He's not on the list, so... Regardless, it's going to be a great matchup and tons of talent on the ice there when it comes up in Montreal.
And if you have never seen a celebration in Montreal, they do it as well as anywhere.
Down the slot comes Kane. Backhand try. Save made by Raycroft. Had to stop the rebound as well. And then the puck is tucked underneath him. And let's take a look at who is not going to the All-Star Game. And these are some big names.
Well, this is not just the Western Conference. This is the NHL. Vanek, Carter, Ovechkin, and Parisi for New Jersey all going, but Kessel, as Kyle just mentioned, with 24 goals on the best club in the East, Sharp, who has, he and Erickson came in tonight tied for most goals in the West with 20. Again, all players deserving to go, and there's right down the list a ton of guys that aren't going.
The point, Seabrook. And the starters are voted by the fans. And then the rest are picks.
With 15 players. Yeah, the hockey operations and the general managers are consulted.
And as I said, it's an unwritten rule.
Right.
And they put a player from each team on the All-Star line, on the All-Star teams.
But now it gets to the point, Mike, a lot of times, it happened the Avalanche last year, when a player is hurt, they don't always go right to that club to replace them.
You're selected last year's
yes.
staff day, but then was not able to go to the All-Star game. This year, Milan-Hayduk
right.
is the only representative. But he was not replaced by another Avalanche. Where in baseball, there has to be somebody from each team. Campbell, the center ice, brought in. Frazier, shot, save. The rebound is there. It is picked up by Clark of the Avs. To center ice, 12 minutes to go. The pass comes across for Wilson. Chopped away. Clark, on a bobbling puck, put it back behind the Chicago net. Around to the far wing. And the Hawks have got it. 1-1 third period. Long pass ahead. Shot wide by Chicago. Slammed by Burst behind the net. Whipped around to the far wing. And behind Brouwer trying to slow it up. He did. He knocked it down, but then wedged away by Dupuis of the Avs. Sent across Wilsey to center. And he will dump it into the Chicago zone. Wisniewski after it. Slides it around to the near wing. Scoop out towards center ice. Brought in by Sharp, coming wide. He shoots. Blocker save made by Raycroft. Played off the glass to center ice. Hawks will get it again. But again, we see these shots, Peter, that the Hawks are getting for the most part. I mean, they're out on the perimeter.
They're from the outside, which is, you know, you want to get pucks on net. But the thing is, the players are then for the Avalanche, turning, making good decisions on where to follow that rebound, where to get that puck, and get it out of the zone.
Yeah, we haven't seen much in Chicago getting that second and third shot, sorry.
And those are the key. I mean, a lot of you, any goaltender tell you, if I can see it, I'll stop it if you take care of the next part of the game.
2-on-1 for Chicago. Havlin coming wide. His pass caught the skate of Hannon. He comes free behind the Avalanche net. Hayduk will get away. Moves to the corner, reverses behind the net. Look to the far wing. Slipped up, not out. Keith holds it in. Whipped it. And Seabrook brought it in. And ruled to be an offside play. Then Bolin and Hannon start pushing each other a little bit. And they are separated. Things calm down.
Like, you talk about what makes a 2-on-1 not effective. Good hustle right here. Look on the left side of your screen. There, that's Soleil coming back. So have it when he looks up. He thinks he's got a man open. He takes a puck wide. He's hoping the defenseman's going to come with him, so his man will be open. And all of a sudden, Soleil, body and stick in the way. There's nothing for Havlat to do.
Avalanche and Chicago will play one more game this season, and that will be on March 8th as that puck goes up into the stands. It didn't hit the screen.
No, it didn't hit the screen. As somebody was watching the TV and just got absolutely smoked. Holy cow. I'll tell you, every time I see a play like that, I look at the screen and go, thank goodness. Why did it take so long? And why did it have to be such a tragedy? Why it's up? But man. Talk about something that just makes sense.
A very young girl was killed in Columbus, and after that happened, the screens went up, and you wonder, is that screen even big enough coming covering it up? Yeah. We just saw.
Yeah, because that guy, I mean, he was, believe me, he did not see it coming. I watched the flight of it, and it was one of those ones where, Mike, unfortunately, I could see him standing going, oh no, he doesn't see it, and just.
Lyles with another chance, and that one is kicked away by Javi Bulla, lifted around the boards. Cannon waiting at the point, keeps it in play in the Chicago zone. McLeod centering pass, knocked down by Walker. McLeod still with another chance. Walker took it away. Dupuy waiting, steals, sends it in front off the chest of Javi Bulla, who makes the save. Back to center off of Cannon's stick. First thing. He's on a three-game goal scoring streak. Just simply wrestled to the ice by Cannon. Not muscle. Brought in by Wilsey. He shoots, and that is deflected into the screen and out of play. Gives us a chance to take a breather. We'll be back in a moment in Denver, Colorado. Our game still tied at one.
Mike, the National Hockey League could not have picked this year a better place to have it. Wrigley Field, a hockey game. Now, the Detroit Red Wings went on to win the game 6-4. But the two clubs and the city of Chicago put on such a show. They were so accessible. They showed the practice the day before, and just everybody had their families out. It was truly a classic time to be a hockey player. The Blackhawks, Mike, how far have they come in the last two or three seasons as far as their credibility back in the hockey world?
I talked to Coach Quenneville this morning about that Winter Classic. His eyes just lit up. He just said it was beyond what you expected. It was so great. Everything was just done perfectly. And I said, what was the best part of it? He said, the fans and how much excitement there was in that Wrigley Field. And it just must have been so much fun to play.
Yeah, and you know, they're not going to dilute it by having it two or three times a year, from what I understand. But right now they are looking at it same time next year, January 1st. At this point, and things could change, obviously. Yep. Fenway has the inside track.
Well, I think the NHL now owns New Year's Day in terms of sports. Sidney Crosby and the Pittsburgh Penguins, who have played in the Winter Classic, come to town to face off against the Avs Saturday afternoon. There are a limited number of tickets still available for that game on Saturday afternoon.
And Mike, we're down to 8:43 remaining in this hockey game. It is really crunch time. It's going to take a very special play, the way these two clubs are playing right now, to get that next goal.
These teams aren't making many mistakes, are they, at all?
No, every time I look up and I see a player coming in through the neutral zone, I'm looking back and I'm seeing four guys on the other team ready for him.
It's not going to be a sloppy play. I don't think that's going to get the goal. It's going to be that hard work. There's a chance for Volski. And robbed by Javi Bulla. Hawks race through center. Brought in, back in and around the board. The Avs have lost to Chicago 6-2 and 4-3. The Avs have been held to one, have held the Hawks to one goal in this game. In the two previous games, a total of 10. The Avs have really shut down Chicago in this one. Smith shot, love, save, Javi Bulla. And he'll hold that one.
Watch the play by Volski. By Volski. Here first is a play by Smith, down low to Volski, who, Mike, again, time after time, you mentioned this was his natural position, and he is naturally going to the right spot on the ice, because every time we show him, he seems to be open with the puck.
Was it a situation, Peter, from the beginning for him, that there were just too many good centermen with the Avalanche when he arrived?
The situation was, Michael, when he got here, you're looking at who's in front of him as far as center iceman. He's a top six forward. He has to play in the top two lines. So for the Avalanche, you're going to put him in a situation. Whoa!
Glove save. Rebound there. Tucker turns. Shoots. Penalty.
And I think it's going to be against Chicago. The Avalanche will get a power play here in the third period.
But Michael, that's not the, I mean, that is obviously a key. But what happened here, the linesman said, you got 15 seconds. Chicago took too much time. He dropped the puck. I've seen it twice this year. Watch the referee. Well, nice, pardon me. He just drops it. He said, get in there. They don't do it. The Avalanche are lined and ready. And again, Hobby Green, who, Mike, in tonight's game anyway, has not frozen the puck. He saw the puck come across to his catching hand. He went to bat it into the corner.
Chicago, number 8, minor penalty, hooking.
I agree. That's the second time I've seen this year. I remember talking to you about that and saying, hey, I just saw him drop the puck.
And I think it was against the Avalanche the first time.
Yes, because Ryan Smith wasn't in the faceoff circle.
Well, but now for the Avalanche. Here we go, Mike Dugabo, given that's, you know, a break in a hockey game. Here it is for Colorado.
Walker off for hooking. Smith will take the draw for the Avalanche. They send out Volsky, Smith, Hayduk, Clark, and Lyles. And a win on the faceoff by the Avs. Shot, Clark missed it. Around the boards. Bouncer, Volsky reaching for it, slugged away. The Avalanche yet to score a power play goal in this season series against the Hawks. 0-10 overall, 0-2 in this game. Clark is in, coming wide. We are tied at 1 in the third period. Bouncer, slides, keeps it in. And Seabrook will take that puck and drill it down the ice. Raycroft. Hard pass ahead, trying to take advantage of the Hawks changing things up. Smith goes free. Smith to the front. Smith back in. Set. And goal! Milan Hayduk. And they add to the power play goal. And much to the frustration of Hobby Bullen, that is a goal for Hayduk. He scores his 14th of the season, and the Avalanche have a 2-1 lead.
But Michael, I'll tell you who makes the play is Raycroft. John Michael Lyles is coming back. He's calling for the puck. Raycroft looked up, saw Chicago changing, and threw it all the way down the ice, which led to this play. Now he's upset, and Hobby Bullen was upset at what? Now I think that might have been Volsky, Mike, who chipped that one in. But either way, now what is Hobby Bullen upset with? There's an action in front. Does he get things stuck under Smith? And Smith pull him across? No, it just looked like.
I think you might be right on Volsky. Hayduk did hit it. It was going in, and then Volsky gave it another tap before it had crossed the line.
But Andrew Raycroft makes that play. If he just goes soft, Mike, and just gives it to the defenseman, he gets aggressive, dumps it up the ice, and the Avalanche catch Chicago. You don't want to say napping, but in the middle of a change, and there's always a little confusion.
So the Avalanche are up 2-1. That is a power play goal for Colorado.
That's their first power play goal since the first period against Detroit.
And first one of the season against the Hawks. One lead for Colorado. They gave it initially to Hayduk on the announcement, and now it has been changed.
Yeah.
So that first there was announcement that Hayduk gets credit. Now Volsky will get credit for the goal. That's his 10th of the season, his second power play goal this year. And let's give you what is now the official word on the Burt Sports scoring summit. It is Volsky at 13:01. And that line on the power play, Hayduk and Smith, the others, getting the assists.
And Mike, you look at it now, that's full back-to-back, multiple-point game for Volsky. 3 goals and assists the last 2 games.
Hayduk continues to pick up assists on the Volsky goals. And the point shot, tip to the front. Oh, that was a chance for Bufflin. Keith shot, save, knocked away. Spinning, Raycroft actually spun around after that save was made. Into the corner, back up the board. Jones has got it, 2-1-1 for the half. The pass, knocked down, but it bounced away from Stewart. And chopped up the boards, whacked back the other way by Clark. And into the Chicago zone. Icing called on the Colorado Avalanche. Avs now lead 2-1 in the third period on the Wojtek Volski power play goal.
But again, what I liked, you have to have liked all night long the Avalanche, is the alert way that they have played this game. I take this play all the way back to Andrew Raycroft, where the puck was down the ice. You know, as I said, the easy thing, Mike, would have been to just touch it, hand it off to the defenseman. He saw that Chicago was changing, and he quickly got it up ice.
Loose puck in front. And the Avs trying to get to it. Ladd took it back on a center, tipped in the air. Set off the glass to center ice. Another difference in this game, Peter. We saw defenseman Brett Clark make a save. Hawks couldn't do it on that left hand. Ladd in the slots, and it goes all the way out towards center ice. Picked up. This is a 2-on-1. Smith and Volski. The pass broken up. As Jim Wisniewski went down to the ice to stop the 2-on-1 for the Avs. Havlik threw it out in front. Raycroft there to make the save. And we will step aside from the Pepsi Center. Andrew Raycroft having a strong game. And the power play goal in the third period has given Colorado the lead.
Well, just looking at the numbers now, Michael, there's been 69 shots on goal, only 3 goals in this hockey game. And we look at the 3 goals, they have all been hard-working goals. The first one by Smith, reviewed. Volski gets the assist. Then in the second period on the power play, Campbell, the all-star defenseman, blasts one by Andrew Raycroft. But in the third period, last game, Volski got the goal that gave the Avalanche a 2-1 lead right here. Another one, this one on the power play. And now, Mike, you look at Chicago Blackhawks down by one. They've got all the guns on one line. Sharp, Taves, Kane, Campbell, all out there for this faceoff.
Taves will take the faceoff against Volski. Taves wins the draw. Wisniewski shoots it across. Around the board, near side, Soleil. Going to chop it out of the zone. Kept in. Taves, poke check by Hajduk to center. Diving back. Wisniewski finds Brian Campbell. And yeah, these are the big guns right out on the ice right for the Hawks. Campbell with it behind the net. Soleil cut it off. Bouncing puck. Sharp finds Campbell deep in the corner. Hawks putting some pressure on to the point. Shot by Wisniewski. There's a chance. Oh, man. It went wide again. Patrick Sharp. He's going to see Raycroft in his dream tonight. He's had so many chances of been robbed by Raycroft. That is now, my count, at least 3 really good chances for Sharp.
Absolutely.
Campbell handed it away. Steal coming in. Save. Rebound. Save again by Hobby Boulin. That one might have put it away. A big save by Hobby Boulin gives Chicago a chance. 3:10 to go. Lifted in. Icing. Called on Chicago. The Hawks, the highest scoring team on a per game average, have been held to just 1 goal in this game by the Avalanche.
And Michael, you look at the goals that have beaten these 2 goaltenders. You look at the one as we're looking at chances right here. Sharp again. You got Smith that bounced in clearly off his leg. Then you had the one by Campbell where the Avalanche were complaining mightily that Raycroft was not allowed to move from left to right on the play. And the last one, Habib Boulin, was taken right out of the net by his own teammates. So those are the only ones that have gotten by these goaltenders tonight.
3 minutes to go. Down the slot comes Butler. Cross ice pass deflected away. Directed off the boards and into the Chicago zone. Banked across near wing. Burstig's got it. The Avalanche applied 2 forecheckers on Chicago. Try to pin them in their own zone. Pass to Wisniewski. Slides it over the line. Burstig down the slot. His pass shot off the side of the net by Bufflin. Picks it up along the far wing. Puts it towards the corner. Good defensive play from Volski. Center ice. Keith got it back. Bufflin comes into his own zone. Wisniewski to center ice. Slips around Volski. Slides it ahead for Keith. Top of the circle on the drop. The shot wide. Around the boards. Wisniewski keeps it in play to the corner. Havlik circle. Could not get the backhander off the drop. Nice pass. Keith. Boom. The shot. And he missed it. Off the glass. Smith clears the zone. 2 minutes to go in the third period. And the Avalanche up by a goal. Wisniewski's pass over the line. Offside on the Chicago Blackhawks. They are pushing the play, but it remains 2-1 in favor of the Avs. Jerome McGinley, Dion Phaneuf, and the Calgary Flames are coming to town on Family Night Sunday, January 18th. You get four tickets, four pizzas, four Pepsis, and it's only $99. Family Night with the Calgary Flames on January 18th.
And again, the big line for you look at the clock, minute 51, sharp tapes, Kane, Campbell. And remember, Chicago still has their timeout remaining in this game.
Offside, though, Kane. Taves was the one ahead of the play just a little bit. So another face-off in the neutral zone.
And how important is this game for the Avalanche? Or how big is it? This is if the Avalanche hold on to win this one, Mike, this will be the first non-Detroit loss since December 1st if the Avalanche can hold on.
Only in the last 13 games for Chicago coming into this one. Two losses to Detroit back-to-back. So only the third loss in 14 games as the Avs iced the puck, which means a faceoff with 91 seconds to go back in the Colorado zone.
And the Avalanche do not have their faceoff. Remember, they took that earlier when they had a group of five that were tired on an icing. So now Arneson becomes the man against Taves on this faceoff.
Here comes Javi Bulin to the bench.
Yep.
The goaltender has been pulled by Chicago, so Javi Bulin gets off the ice. Boxer with six skaters out, and the key is a faceoff. Avs trying to get a hold of the puck and get it out. Kane, double teamed along the wall, picked up and chipped out to center by McLeod. And a race for the puck. Vanos will get to it. Vanos behind the net. Hit, loses the puck. Campbell fires it out to center ice. Hawks trying to catch up to it. It is brought in by Verstig. Onside, the pass. And poke check held in by the Hawks. Wisniewski, pass across, shot in front, and it's tipped wide, slammed around the boards, got out, Wisniewski holds it in, has a little pressure, goes across, in the slot, cross for Taves, 50 seconds to go, back to the point, oh, nice play by Wisniewski to keep that bouncing puck in. Campbell, back around the boards, centered by Kane, Langley, loose puck to the corner, still in play, 38 seconds to go, Kane top of the near circle, down low, pass, dead shot, the save, it's knocked down, loose puck behind the net, centered out in the slot, broken up by Hannon, Taves after to the point, Campbell behind his back, Snooski in the near circle, Kane turns, shoots it, blocked, and stretching, Campbell kept it in, 19 seconds, shot, save, and it goes off the right cross and wide, 15 seconds left, Campbell, near side, Wisniewski, wide, fire, save, 10 seconds left, and Raycroft makes the big save. You enjoying this one? You better. This is as good as it gets in hockey.
And the great part about it was Chicago had about four plays where they kept the puck in the zone. They did everything they could, and the Avalanche just kept rotating and rotating, kept things clear in front of the net. As much as there was pandemonium going on, an extra attacker for the Blackhawks, the Avalanche never found themselves running around in the zone. They were going from good spot to good spot. Chicago had control of puck. Chicago had a couple of good shots. But there is the man of the hour for the Avalanche. It's, I mean, Mike looking to go 8-1, looking to win his sixth straight game for the Avalanche. He's made 44. He's faced 44, made 43. And this is Chicago's Chicago Blackhawks timeout right here. And this is one of those classic moments where one faceoff and you can ice it, Michael. Not no problem if you ice the puck now if you're the Avalanche. If there's 20 seconds, you don't. If you're the Avalanche right now, it doesn't matter. It'll put it down to a second, maybe two.
Coach Granato goes with Ryan Smith on the draw. Sharp for the Hawks. Campbell is back. And the win, oh, but it goes off the glass and out of the zone. And the Hawks trying to get back into the Avalanche in. 3 seconds to go. Smith will tie it up, and that's it. The Avalanche beat the Chicago Blackhawks. What a game. What a game tonight. Andrew Raycroft with 43 saves. Wojtek Volski with a game winner again. That is two games in a row now, Peter, that he has had the game-winning goal. And Raycroft with two wins in these last two games for the Avs.
And I would have to say, Michael, if it was an experiment for Volski, it is now officially
over. Oh, yeah.
It is now. You can take that LW beside his name and just in ink, put a C. He is now a center for this Colorado Avalanche club. As this club worked hard and worked smart against a very good offensive club, But you can point to a whole bunch of different things. But Andrew Raycroft was absolutely brilliant for the Avalanche again.
Very entertaining game, and the Avalanche do get the victory. We'll have tonight's announcement of three stars, and here it is.
Tonight's three stars of the game are selected by Mark Mosier of the Altitude Radio Network. Tonight's third star from the Avalanche with a goal number 94, Ryan Smith. Tonight's second star from the Avalanche with the game-winning goal number 8, Wojtek Volski. And tonight's number 1 star with 43 saves in his 8th win of the year, number 1, Andrew Raycroft. Our number 1 star is standing by with Kyle Keefe.